Hey everyone, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. Just recently, the people at Logitech reached out to me and asked if I would like to review MX Creative Console. So I was actually very happy to do it because I'm already a big fan of Logitech and I've been using their gear for a long time. I've been using their mice and peripherals for as long as I can remember. They're just, in my opinion, the best ones out there. So I'm more than happy to be looking at the MX Creative Console today, which consists of two parts. It consists of the dial and the keypad. Let's have a look right now. And this video is sponsored by Logitech. So this is the MX Creative keypad, which gives us instant tool access right at our fingertips. This has 9 full color LCD buttons, adjustable brightness, and 2 paging buttons where we can have up to 15 pages of actions per app. But if we use different profiles, it extends it so we have unlimited. So this can either be used flat or with the included stand here, we can put it in up at an angle. And then we can also tuck the cable away. So we're gonna plug that into USB-C. Then we're gonna take the second component here, which is the MX Creative dial pad. This is a high precision, low carbon aluminum dial with friction bearings, and it feels really nice. And we use this to adjust different parameters. We also have a fluid roller here, so we can zoom in and out, as you can see on the screen or other things. We have 4 different buttons that can be programmed to do a variety of different functions. Now, this runs on 2 AAA batteries. Now, maybe some people might like to use both of these with one hand, so maybe you'll tap and go there. So the nice thing about this being separate into 2 modules means you can set this up however you want. You can have them together, one side, the other side, left hand, right hand, it doesn't matter. You've got complete creative freedom. So here's something well worth mentioning. When you get the MX Creative Console, it comes with 3 months of Adobe Creative Cloud subscription included for free. Now that doesn't matter. If you're an existing subscriber, you'll get 3 months added. And if you're a new subscriber, obviously you get 3 months for free. And that gives really good value considering the price of the MX Creative Console. So I expected this would be more expensive than it is. It's selling for $199 in the United States for both of these. So once you've got these plugged in, we're going to be installing the application, the Options Plus. This is a brand new application. Now this is the dial. If I go to the keypad, we can go through the different pages. Now there's a third piece to this, and that's the Actions Ring. The action ring is really interesting because you can also set a lot of different parameters in here as well. So I can roll over here and if I want, I can use the dial to make these adjustments. And all I do is just roll over them with the mouse. Look at that. And as an added bonus, if it's something you want to adjust and you don't want to reach for there, you can just use the scroll wheel on the mouse. So that's a great thing about this MX ecosystem, how everything just works together really nicely. All right, so let me show you how I use this in Photoshop. So this is where it saves time. So say, for example, I want to create a curves adjustment layer. I can just tap there and it will create that curves adjustment layer for me. And so that saved me a couple of clicks. And why don't I just darken this a little bit? We're going to paint in some shadow to this image. So I could use the dial to change the size of my brush and it feels really nice. Like it's very precise and I can also adjust the sensitivity of it. So, you know, if I want to go in here and start painting some shadow on there, I could do that. But I could go beyond that. Like, say I hit this brush folder. Look at this. Now I have the ability, I can use this for the size of the brush. But if I want to change the hardness, I just tap there. Now I'm changing the hardness of my brush. So I want to, you know, a hard edged. I can just kind of do that. Let me just show you. There's a hard edge. Turn it the other way. Now we've got a soft edge. So it's very, very quick and easy to do that. And then there's other things we can adjust here, like the flow. If I want to lower the flow, which I do a lot when I'm dodging and burning, I'll drop that flow down to, I don't know, around 9 is pretty nice. Now, sometimes there's things you might want to customize in here, like have access to, say, my actions. So I'm going to launch the Options Plus app here. And, you know, maybe I want some actions. So I'm just going to go in here. I'm going to choose Customize Key. And then under the system actions, I can drag anything I want onto here. So say, for example, I wanted to go into Photoshop. And under Photoshop, I want to, you know, maybe do some of my actions, but I'm going to create a brand new page. So I'm going to click here, and then when I use that page button, that enables me to add more. And I'm going to grab my actions, but I'm going to use my user actions. So these are not the ones that come with Photoshop. These are ones that I created myself. And things I like to do things like luminosity masks. So there's a midtone, there's a light luminosity mask. Sometimes I like to expand a selection I can't spell by 10. I might do a dodge and burn. And, you know, just things like this that I might do, a frequency separation. And now I can just go through, there's my pages. So if I go in here now and I want to do, like, say, maybe a dodge and burn, I just tap here, continue. And look at this, it created my dodge and burn layers for me, and I'm ready to go. So I can set actions in here. I can create adjustment layers. I can create a lot of different things. When I switch between applications, this will automatically be application sensitive. So if I want to go into Lightroom and do some work, I want to create a radial gradient. Well, you know what we got to do. We've got to go into the mask and we've got to click through several steps. But now I can just tap and it will create all the steps and my radial gradient is ready. And I can just drag it out like that. And then I can make those adjustments to it. You know, I could use the dial to do that. There's different ways I could set it up. And another place where this could save a lot of time is in Premiere Pro. Notice it goes in there and already it's selecting Premiere and we can page through the different things. So one of the things I do a lot when I'm doing my tutorials is I do a ton of cropping. And, you know, I have to go into the effects. I've got to find the effects and then I go in, I find the crop, then I drag it on here. But if, say, I wanted to crop this, I can just simply say, hey, let's crop the top. Just like that, grab the wheel. And look at this, I'm cropping the top just like that. If I want to crop the bottom, let's hit the bottom there. And now I'm just cropping it. Look at this, it's such a huge time saver, you know. Let's go back into the options plus. And in here, you know, we can go to Premiere Pro. And let's look at adding these different profiles. Just click on the all actions. And then at the bottom here, you're going to see a button where it will take us to the marketplace. And here we are in the marketplace right now. And in the marketplace, we can see we've got profiles and plugins. So as you can see, the major Creative Cloud apps are already here and are already installed. We've got After Effects, Premiere Pro, Lightroom Classic, Photoshop, Illustrator, Audition. These are all installed. It goes beyond that. If we go to profiles, we can actually go to something that maybe we do have a plugin for, but we can choose Photoshop. And we can see there's different profiles. So these profiles are sets of presets. And we just simply click add. And we choose where we want to put them. And we're just going to choose add. And now they're done. And so when you're in Photoshop now, you'll see these profiles have been added. And we can choose those. And notice the settings on here are specific to that profile. I could go to retouch one. And this is going to give me different tools. And the other thing that's neat, if there is an application that there isn't a plugin for, that's fine. You can just hit the add profile and then under here you can create an application profile and then you can add a different application in here and then you can just build your own keyboard shortcuts for pretty much anything. And this is going to be growing and we're going to be seeing profiles, plugins, we're going to be seeing icon packs and different things in here. So the nice thing about that too is it also future proofs this, so as new stuff comes out, we're able to go into the marketplace and download different things. So it has this easy button. So you can connect to three different devices through the Bluetooth and then switch between them one at a time. And if you don't want to use Bluetooth, you can also connect through this USB bolt. So that's another option. Sometimes when I review some gear, I might try it out for the review, but then I don't really end up using it. But this is one of those pieces of gear that I will be using every day. I find it really useful, especially if there's actions that would take two or three clicks or having to dig and drag on a menu to just be able to just hit one button and do it. To me, that time saving and that convenience is just going to free me up to be more creative. So anyway, I'm curious, what do you guys think? Drop a comment underneath. And if you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.